Probably if you open this video, you may have wondered why your renders don't look as photorealistic as you expected. What many people don't realize is that achieving photorealism isn't just about having a powerful PC, it's about mastering the right techniques. In fact, it doesn't require as much effort as you might think. I'll show you the key points that allows you to achieve photorealism in Blender in this simple example, but it all applies to any projects. I already made a video about photorealism in Blender and then talked about one of the most important things in realism – details. Realism requires small and often overlooked elements. Imagine you are creating a wood table like this one. It's not sufficient to simply apply a wood texture. You must also incorporate small structures, subtle layers of dust and natural variation in the wood grain. The more details, the better result you will get. That is why we can use Megascan's texture with normal map and displacement. I apply normal map to give the surface depth. Bump normal simulates tiny bumps and grooves, making the texture look and feel real. For added realism, displacement map are also a great tool. They create even thinner details on the surface, enhancing the texture's complexity. In Blender, we may use displacement texture in different ways. If you need true displacement, change displacement settings to displacement only or displacement and bump. In this case, you also need more dense mesh, but you will get a really detailed surface, or you may use only bump. In this case, nothing happens with your surface, but you still get realistic details if you use light in the right position. It means to achieve photorealism, we also need light. I talked a lot about light and I have separate playlist about light. You may find it in the corner links. Lighting is crucial for photorealism. The right lighting has the power to turn a simple scene into something extraordinary, emphasizing important details. It's not enough to just put the light in the Blender scene. It's necessary to find the lighting scheme to emphasize everything. You can use the classic 3D point light system or find your own. Also, I often use HDRI lights. HDRI provides realistic lights by simulating how light interacts with the environment. You can find plenty of free HDRIs online that suit different moods and settings. You have to play with light, trying to catch some glare to glossy surface, change the temperature of the light. The main light may be cold light, but other warmer light and HDRI for ambient light. That brings also a picturesque effect into your render. Of course, to achieve photorealism, we need to set up our camera correctly. The key to achieving photorealism is understanding how the real cameras work. In this case, I use a 50mm lens because it provides a natural perspective similar to what the human eye sees. And the magic lies in this feature of the camera settings – depth of field. Enabling depth of field in the camera settings allows you to blur the background slightly. Even not only background, it works for the foreground too. In a nutshell, it allows us to highlight focus point like in the real camera. When you focus on target object using real camera, everything in front and behind the object is blurred. Adjusting the f-stop and the camera settings control how much of the scene is in the focus. A lower f-stop values create a deep effect of depth of field, perfect for close-ups and emphasizing the main subject or character. But try to avoid some unrealistic values. Would be better to work with unreal f-stop values related to existing lens values. Post effects are what can turn everything into a realistic picture. Using good texture, light and adding some details, we can achieve realism. But to get photorealism, we need to some post effects that will imitate the photo, like it's not a 3D render or captured on mirrorless or DSLR camera. In Blender, we can use compositing to add all these effects and, of course, here we can do some post-production like color grading to avoid spending a lot of time trying to set up everything. Into this scene, we can do some small adjustments in order to bring the result to perfect without using external programs. As I often say, the Blender is enough for many tasks to make the whole result inside Blender only. So, in other words, photorealism is not in the ideal of everything. The less idyllic material, the more natural they look to us. Also, in order to achieve photorealism, it's necessary to follow the logic of working as a real camera, because the camera in the 3D program is deprived of all those moments that are present in the real camera, like noise from lack of light. Do not confuse it with the digital noise from lack of samples, it's a different noise. Also, lens distortion and vignetting that appears with the optics. This is such a paradox. Photographers constantly try to get rid of all these artifacts in order to get idyllic photos. But we, as a digital artist, have to recreate all these artifacts to get cinematic and photorealistic images. Because the real camera follows the law of physics and the 3D camera is devoid of all law and works by algorithms. So it turns out that by default the picture created in 3D environment don't look like a photo. That's the reason why your renders aren't realistic, because they are so perfect. In general, 3D artists have a good advantage in front of photographers. We do not need to search for object or create some situation, light and create nice shot. Instead, we can do everything in 3D without a lot of stuff. Believe me, sometimes to find something with a camera in your hand is really hard. With 3D graphics, you do not need to even go out to shoot something. But we have to remember that the way to photorealism is in physical properties. In this way, it turns out that to achieve photorealism, we need to get rid of the perfection of the digital image. And that's fact, because it's a perfect 3D image that reveals the effect that is created on computer. So, to achieve photorealism in 3D work, we need to consider all these facts, such as detailing, physical camera, lighting, and post effects. And the main answer to the question of whether we need a computer the size of the nuclear reactor to achieve photorealism, no, it's more impact on the size of the scene you can work with, but definitely not on photorealism.